So the vanilla RC is what is called the eager release consistent memory model. And the new memory model is called LRC, or lazy release consistent memory model. Let's see the pros and cons of LRC with respect to vanilla RC, or lazy RC with respect to eager RC. So what I'm showing you here are timelines of processor actions on three different processors, P1, P2, and P3. And this picture is showing you what happens in the eager version of the RC model in terms of communication among the processors. So when processor P1 has completed its critical section, does a release operation at the release point, what we're going to do is all the changes that we made in this example I'm showing you, to make it simple, I'm showing you that in this critical section, I wrote to this variable X. So the changes to X is going to be communicated to all the processors, P2 and P3. It could be depending on whether it is an invalidation-based protocol or an update-based protocol. What we are saying is we are communicating the coherence action to all the other processors. That's what these arrows are indicating. Now then, P2 acquires the lock, and after it acquires the lock, it does its own critical section. Again, let's say we're writing to the same variable X, and it releases the lock. And at the point of release, once again, we broadcast the changes that we made. Notice what is going on. P1 makes modifications, broadcasts it to everybody, but who really needs it? Well, only P2 needs it. But unfortunately, the RC memory model is eager, and it says, I'm going to tell everybody that has a copy of X that I have modified X, and so it's going to tell it to P2, it's going to tell it to P3 as well. P3 doesn't care because it's not using that variable yet, and P2 cares, and it of course is using that. But when it releases its critical section, it's once again going to do exactly the same thing that happened over here, and that is it's going to broadcast the changes it made to shared memory locations to all the other processors, in this case P1 and P2. And then finally, P3 does its acquire and then reads the variable. So all these arrows are showing you the coherence actions that are inherent in the completion of shared memory accesses that are happening in the critical section of programs. Now let's move over to the lazy version. In the lazy version, what we are doing is when we release the lock, we are not doing any global communication. We simply release the lock. Later on, the next process that happens to acquire that same lock, the RC memory model, the first thing it's going to say is, oh, you want to get this lock? I have to go and make sure that I complete all the coherence actions that are associated with that particular lock. In this case, the previous lock holder had made changes to the variable X, so I'm going to pull it from this guy, and then I can execute my critical section. And then when P3 executes its critical section, it's going to pull it from P2 and complete what it needs to do. So the important thing that you see is that there is no broadcast anymore. It's only point-to-point communication that's happening between the processors that are passing the lock between one to the other. So in other words, the number of arrows that you see are communication events. You can see that there's a lot more arrows here. Forget about the arrows that I introduced, but the black arrows that you see are the arrows that are indicating communications commensurate with the coherence actions needed for this set of critical section actions. And correspondingly, the black arrows here are showing the communication actions for the same set of critical section actions shown in both the top and the bottom half of this particular figure. You can see there's a lot less communication happening with the lazy model. It's also called a pull model because what we're doing is at the point of acquisition, we are pulling the coherence actions that need to be completed over here. Whereas this is a push model in the sense that we are pushing out the coherence actions to everybody at the point of release. Having introduced the eager and the lazy RC models, it's time for a quiz.